Welcome to the practical of fluid mechanics. In this fluid mechanics practical today, we will be learning the practical of viscosity, which is the study of viscosity of oil using red hot viscometer. The objective of this practical is to study the variation of kinematic viscosity of an oil using red hot viscometer. Red hot viscometer is a device which is used to calculate the viscosity of a given oil. Now the details of the red hot viscometer will be given by Nifari sir.
Specifications of viscometer. The diameter of the cylinder is 47.625 mm. Height of the cylinder is 88.90 mm. Diameter of orifice is 1.7 mm. Length of orifice is 12 mm.
Pause. Now this is the red hot viscometer device. So in this, with the help of this device, we'll be calculating the viscosity of a given oil. So the oil used for this practical is the mustard oil. So we'll be using this oil and we'll be pouring this oil into this cylinder. Now this is the cylinder. As the dimension of the cylinder is mentioned, that it is nearly the diameter is nearly 47 mm. The height of the cylinder is nearly 88 mm. So we'll be pouring the oil in this section, and to measure we need to measure the temperature, as the objective is to measure the temperature. So we'll be needing the temperature thermometer. So we'll be using this thermometer over here like this, and we can measure the temperature of the bath. Now the next thing is that this cylinder is having a conical bottom and having a hole. That hole is known as the orifice, through which the oil will be coming and it will be collected in this beaker. Now, and it will be kept like this to collect the beaker.
Start.
Now we will pour the water bath, and so that we can maintain the temperature which is poured in this. We'll be filling this water up to the top of the cylinder.
Start.
Now we can see the oil is the water is up to the top of this cylinder. Now we'll be pouring this mustard oil into this. But you can see that whenever I am pouring this, it will the oil is coming down through this. So we need to have a control on this. So to have the control on the discharge, we are using this ball valve. So this ball valve controls the discharge. So like this we can stop it. Whenever I'll be removing this ball valve, the water the oil will be coming out through this orifice which is provided at the bottom. So now I'm stopping it. This water bath is provided with electric heater. Now we'll be starting that electric heater to heat the oil. Now I'm starting this oil. So here this electric heater will be heating this oil, heating this water bath, and that water bath will be heating the oil which is kept in the cylinder. Now we'll be seeing the temperature of this water bath, and the oil has reached nearly 31 degrees. It has been observed in the thermometer. Now I will be closing the water heater over here. Now I will be putting this beaker, and in this beaker we have to collect nearly 50 ml or 50 cm cube of this oil over here. And I will be recording the time required which is for collecting this oil. Now as I am increasing, I am using this stopwatch, I am removing this simultaneously and starting this stopwatch. So I have removed this, now I am collecting this, and now this stopwatch is started.
and it is being collected in this beaker.
2, 3. Now we can see it has been collected. It is required for collecting this oil. So the total we can calculate it as 168 seconds. So this is our first reading. Now what I will be doing, I have stopped this now over here. Now again whatever is the collected thing will be putting again in this cylinder. And now again I will be increasing the temperature. Now I will be increasing this temperature with 5 degrees. We can take any increment, but generally we take it as 5 degrees. Now again I am stopping, I am starting this and I am putting this thermometer over here. And I will be stopping this heater whenever this thermometer gives me the reading of 37 degrees. Now we can see the temperature has reached nearly 31 degrees in this thermometer. Now we will be stopping this electric heater. And now we will be collecting the oil in this beaker, and we will be collecting nearly 50 ml in this beaker. While collecting it, we will be measuring the time required to collect the oil in this beaker. So I am starting this. And we'll be collecting this oil. Now the time has started to collect this in this beaker. Now we can see it is nearly reached 50 ml. So we'll be stopping this. So now we can see we have collected 50 ml in this beaker. It is nearly 51 ml. Now again we will be pouring this into the cylinder. And again I am keeping this over here like this, which is required to be kept. And now again I am keeping the thermometer. Now we can give an increment of 5 degrees. So the next temperature will be 31 plus 5, which is equal to 36 degrees. Now I will be again starting this electric heater. Now we can see the temperature has reached nearly 36 degrees. Now we can stop it again. Again the same procedure is repeated. I will be starting it. Now the temperature will be started. Now again measuring the time. Now we can see it is nearly filling. Now it is to be stopped. Now after doing the observations, now we will be taking down all these readings in the observation table. Now for the first reading, the observation was 31 degrees. For that, the time required for collecting was 136 seconds. Similarly, for the second reading, we have taken an increment of 5 degrees, which was 36 degrees. And the time required to collect that was 115 seconds. Now, how to calculate the viscosity? Now, let us see this table over here. Now, the first thing is to calculate the discharge. Discharge is equal to volume upon time. So, volume collected was 50 centimeter cube, and the time required for the first reading was 136 seconds. So, we'll be taking this over here. So, 50 divided by 136, which is equal to 0.367 centimeter cube per second. The unit is centimeter cube because we have taken this in 50 centimeter cube over here. Therefore, the unit is 0.36 centimeter cube per second. Next is area of orifice. Here the area of orifice is calculated with the formula pi by 4 into d square. So the diameter of orifice is 1.7 mm. So we need to convert that into centimeter first, and then we can calculate it. Then the answer is 2.267 centimeter square. The next is to calculate the velocity of the flow which is flowing through that orifice, which is equal to discharge upon area. So we have calculated discharge over here, which is equal to 0.367 divided by area, which is calculated in the second step over here. So which is equal to 2.267, which gives us the answer as 0.162 centimeter per second. So the third and the final, the fourth and the final thing is to calculate the kinematic viscosity. So we are having the formula for calculating the kinematic viscosity as 0.026T minus 1.175 divided by T. So 0.026T represents the time taken for collecting the 50 mm oil. So 0.026 multiplied by 136 seconds minus 1.175 divided by time. So final answer is 1.34 centimeter square per second. The kinematic viscosity is 1.34. So like this, we have done the calculation over here. And next we will be calculating the graph.
Now after this doing the calculation, we have to plot the graph. On the y-axis the temperature will be there, and on the x-axis the kinematic viscosity will be there. And from the graph we can observe that as the temperature is increasing, the kinematic viscosity is decreasing. So we can conclude that for liquids, as the temperature increases, the viscosity decreases. Thank you very much.